Hello everyone, this is Cipher Deck, and today we're going to be playing Weroden, and he is my now level 40 Shaman. I've been trying to buck it, not really, I've just been enjoying myself playing this character. Last night we went to Kale, and I was able to get some legs for this fellow. I just need to get the faction, and of course get the gems, which are pretty cheap for priests. So that shouldn't be a problem, just the faction being that I started off as an ogre means that I got to work a little bit harder to get that faction built up. So I plan to work on that probably later today. Probably should do it before this evening because my duo partner is getting on probably around 7 or so. And it's probably like 5 or 6 in the morning at the moment. But today we're going to start working on our epic. This is one thing I wanted to make sure that I started doing, and then also wanted to check on a mob, see if I'm able to solo them yet. What I'll do is I'll bind myself. Ooh, if I bind myself there, then that means I can't get back to the other place faster. I'm not really worried about that. I kind of want to just see if I can solo her yet. But we're going to see if we can't solo this individual for experience. Oh, we could also probably try to see if we can get the Woe and Envy, but I don't know if there's any kind of talking that's involved in that. Let's not worry about killing the person I was going to kill. Let's see about killing the person that drops the Woe and Envy. I don't know how strong they are. I don't know if it's even possible to solo it. But we're going to give it a go after we get this part done. So the first part we need to do is you need to kill one of four different named individuals who are considered pirates or bandits or whatever you want to call them. And once you kill them, it spawns a spirit. And then that spirit is who I need to talk to. So that is as much as I know thus far, and then we will go on to doing the next bit, which is in Freeport, I believe. So we'll see how that all goes. We're almost around there. We're almost to the around the corner to where it is. Now, I was watching a long time ago, Super Bits and Bobs was over here, and he said at level 40 he was soloing a single mob, and I don't know where it is. So this is the person I was talking about. She is blue to me, and you can kill her for a while. She's really good experience. None of the other people in here will assist her. She does cast, though. She's a mean, mean caster. So if you're going to be taking her on, you want to make sure that you have, I don't know, something to protect yourself, like have your pet attacking her. While you put your dots on, maybe try to find a corner or something where you can pull her to. But we are here for Blindy the Cut Purse. So I'm going to just, I'm going to pull with Scourge. Make him hurt a little bit. And I wanted to talk about the different spell types that you get as a shaman. I think they're pretty cool, and I really enjoyed them. One thing I think is kind of nice, being that I am an ogre and have that stun resistance, I find that I can get two dots going on a mob, and by the time I am ready to root them, I already have them to 50%, and my health is barely moved. The only reason it's moved is because I've cannied, and it's great. I love it. But it costs 330 mana to cast both of your dots. So that's something that you have to worry about. I don't know why I'm following you. The dot is going to kill you. Hey, spirit. Okay. Let's make sure attack is not on. And hail. The spirit. Hail the spirit. Let me target the spirit, please. Can I target? There we go. Hail. Did you take this person's life, Shaman? Yes. Why did you take this person's life, Weroden? Did he threaten your life? Did he dislike, did you dislike him, or was his death to profit to a profit to you? He threatened, if I can spell correctly. My life. I see. It brings me sadness to see another die. But his heart was black and as great and a great nothingness. His body will become the grass now. Thank you for what you have done, Shaman. What are you? What or who I am isn't as important as what or who we are. Do you wish to know more, Shaman? Yes. Why have you taken? Oh, no. Say, I wish to know more. There we go. It says that it's good, Verodon. Take this gem. It is part of us, like the clouds and the sky and the wonderful gifts from the grandfather. Take this gem to where the humans gather to spoil the land and water. Some call it a port. There you will find one of us, a shaman like yourself. Give him the gem, and perhaps he will tell you more of the spirits. Okay. So let's go ahead and put the gem there. Thank you, sir. Oh, hello. Hey, guy. What? What? Who? You're named? You're a red one. I'm out of here. Okay. Well, the whole. I don't even know who he is for. Ogre Fiend. Oculus. I mean, you should be of my kin. Why do you attack me? You're like, well, see, here's my question, as far as the Cyclopses go. In the lore of, say, the mythological lore of the Greeks or the Romans, the Cyclopses are born from Poseidon, the god of the water or the oceans. So is he or are the Cyclopses here of the god Praxis? Let's see. Can I get a slow on him? Nope. That's a solid no, sir. But he's not hitting hard. But he is red as all get out. I'm gonna have to look him up. Yeah, I don't know if they are bound by Praxis or if they are of Ralozek, which is what I am and other giants are. So that's something that's interesting. I need to look that up a little bit. Since we're running and we have some grace period or some room, I am going to go ahead and check to see if the Woe Envy guy is up. And if he is, I'm going to con him and then I'm going to zone this guy and then look him up. Oculi. Okay, wait a minute. This is a note. Let me make sure I'm not showing you anything. Brute caves. Nope. Nothing there. All right. Let's go ahead and VP key. Yeah. There's that. Oculys. Ogre. Fiend. We'll look him up between zoning and coming back. Actually, oh, my levitation's gone. One of the things I always thought was weird, is that levitation only lasts 8 minutes. No matter what level you are, 8 minutes is how long it lasts. The bard version, there's a bard song that gives levitation and movement speed. That lasts 4 minutes. Am I at the right place? I am at the right place. Okay. That one lasts 4 minutes. So here's my question on the whole thing is, why is it that there has never been... I'm thinking now. Just think for a second and think about the other classes that have levitate. Never mind. I was going to say, why is there not a longer duration levitation? And then to that you would say, the necromancer version, which is... Oh, hey, he is up. Let's see what level he is. Did I tether? Did I break the tether thing? Or is he still coming after? He's blue. Okay, let's sit here a second and see if we get somebody slapping us around. And while we wait, I am going to get a pet memed. A pet, I say. But there's only one pet. So the way I've organized my book is that these are the things that I'm always going to be using. Shrink, because I'm an ogre. Root, of course. Haste, and then canny of the current version and my current pet. And gate, by infinity also. Always have those on my front page. No matter what class it is, if it's my cleric, I always have... DAs, my two DAs up, my buffs, my main buff line, all my three main heal line, and then throughout the book it's organized. So from here we lead on to healing, then so, and I usually use Scale of Wolf whenever I'm traveling instead of Blood of Wolf, Spirit of Wolf. Is that guy ever going to come? Hopefully not. If he doesn't, then I'm good with that. Then I have Health, Strength, Dex, Agility, Charisma, Slows. And this needs to be organized because I kind of want to get this whittled down to 2 here. And then this whittled down to, say, 4 or less. Maybe 2. So what I ended up doing is, once you get past this, you have your malice, you also have your disempower. This is not really a spell that goes anywhere in particular. It's a debuff for disease spells. Go on under fire. I'm kind of wasting time here a second just to see if this guy's going to come back at me. And I think he's not, so I'm kind of happy about that. Cures, summons, miscellaneous needed, and then also this spell I have never used. It's kind of like the variant of Avatar, I guess, but very, very, very crappy. And then we go to page book 30, and this is where I started throwing junk. Probably going to put all my poison stuff that I am not using on these pages. And, yeah. All right. Well, I'm going to say we're clear. I don't think he's coming. And if he is, hopefully we will have this guy dead before that point ends up happening. All right. Get a pet here. And I got so on. It just feels like I don't because I'm so freaking big. Okay. Hello, buddy. How's it going? I need your woe and envy. He is indifferent to me. Oh, that's me. He is indifferent to me as well. I hope this doesn't get me killed. I'll run if it's going to. But I'm going to see, let's just do it. Let's just try it out. What's going to happen? I'm going to have to cast dots more than once or something. Oh, he is dead. Did I get the other one on him? I didn't. Oh, you're dotting me now? With your Shadow Knight buffs? Or your Shadow Knight dots? Thank you for buffing me, sir. I guess we'll go ahead and attack. And we'll slow him. And I'm gonna root him. He's dead. I hope this is... Oh, and he does have him in his hand. Look at that. One with Envy. This is so much easier than I thought it was going to be. But he has stacked dots on me like nothing else. Alright, let's go ahead and just give herself a quick little heal. Pet is not... Oh, he's running. Is he running or is he on me? Oh, okay. I can take your little hit. Sure you want to tussle? Want to wrestle with the muscle? Yes. All right. Well, this is a later part in the epic, but I got it. That was so much easier than I thought it was going to be. All right. Let's throw this here and that there. Boom. And this one is the secondary... And that is the primary. And it's a piercing. Okay, so I can actually wear these. I kind of want to. Boom. Throw that in there with all my poison stuff. Not poison. I'm on my rogue. Oh, I can't wear it as a shaman? What the heck, man? That was like the cool thing was gonna be that. Oh well. Alright, well, we've got him. The next part is going to be in Freeport, and sadly I still have yet to get a shovel or a broom or any of those. I should probably do a little bit of Kazakh Thule alligators at some point, because there's a pillage enchantment item that drops down there, but there's a lot of them. Even if I was to go to the very end of that area, I'd still get swarmed by like four or five, and I don't think I can handle four mobs, especially when it takes more than 300 mana per dot cycle or per mob. So that's like three, or I could probably take out five mobs right now with Canny. But, yeah. Let me go ahead and get to Freeport, and we'll get that part done today. This is fun. I'm enjoying it. I'm getting stuff done for my epic. I'm going to be epic'd up probably in a year, you know. But I do want to get the stuff done so it is done. And I think I just walked into, hi. Threateningly. What? Okay. Anyway, I'll meet you in Freeport. Okay, so here we are in North Freeport. We are going to follow the left wall here, and we are going to con everybody. Make sure we don't get killed, because I do not want to run from Inethul Swamp again. Well, Wait a minute. I'm confused. No. Let's try this out. Who's Shaman? Shaman. Oh my god. Let me try this out. I may be wrong. Okay, there we go. So he said, he burps in my face and he says, "Fool, you have nothing I want, and certainly have nothing that you want." Okay, so I need to give him the gem. That to him. Okay, now I need to go ahead and invis. Oh, jeez. Follow him. Please don't stop here. He's supposed to stop and say something along the lines of, do you care what I spend my money on? Or something like that. Or what I spend this on. Something like that. I got 1% experience off of that. Woo! Come on, please don't be near guards when you stop. Oh my god, hello, hi, hello, friend. Okay. Okay, let's go in. I already hear it. He is up. I'm confused. I'm confused about this. He should have said something already. Okay, let me read here real quick. Wow, thanks. This must be worth a fortune. I could, Here you are, my friend. Okay, let's go ahead and click off of this. Hail. Say, okay. Greetings, Shaman. Tell me, do you follow justice or hate? I follow hate. Oh, that would have been bad. War. Okay, let's see what he says here. Wow, that's a lot of stuff he just said. While I do not agree with how you go about your existence, we do trust, okay, trust is highlighted, that how you go about your existence, I got lost there for a second. We do trust that your place in the world and the whole is important. You may think you enslave and command us with the powers of gods, with the powers your gods grant you, but we are aware of your intentions and accept them. You are a hunter, and the spirits are your prey. However, there are times when we, the true spirits and those like you can work together to achieve goals, whether mutual or not. Mutual? Yeah. Mutual. We're not. Some help us willingly, and some we make deals with. Regardless of the intentions, these special individuals are also known as the Heyoka. Say, what is Heyoka? Hey, oh my goodness, this is the worst. Okay, there it is. The Heyoka are our mortal counterparts. Some are our friends who seek to help us in whatever goals we deem important. Some seek nothing more than to enslave and command us to do their bidding. We accept this and often make deals with those who those we realize are powerful enough to accomplish what needs to be done. To judge such individuals, we have prepared a test. We ask that before we enter into these contracts, the shaman walk the path of the Heyoka. We see you may be worthy. Will you walk the path? You will be rewarded for your efforts. Say, okay, 1 second. I gotta put this gem in here, whatever it is, an opaque gem. Say, I will walk the path. Okay, let's do... Wow, I need a... I don't know, I didn't do this earlier. But... That is good, Weroden. You will need to walk 3 paths before you can reach that of the Great Spirit, that of the Heyoka. The paths of patience, wisdom, and might. First, you must learn patience. Take this gem and the, take this gem and go on a pilgrimage to an isle in the great water, in Erd's Crossing. Okay, the Kira's, there are our allies and can show you our next contact, Ugalin. Okay. Note. By the way, Oculus Ogre Fiend, he drops Totemic Armor, apparently. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. And we are going for... Oh my goodness, I just lost it again in there. Da-da-da. Kara's... There it is. And boom. O-O-G-L-Y-N. Give Ogalin the gem and do what she asks. As you cannot pick up a lore item you already possess. Remember? Okay. You cannot pick up. Okay. So I see what it is. No matter what path I would have gone in the conversation, I would have gotten this gem. And it's just saying that I, by finishing this portion the way I did, that it is giving me the gem for that. Okay, cool. All right, let me bring this back down to whatever. So I'm probably going to be doing this all in the same day, or a lot of it. So the next video will just take off from today. And I will be in Kinos heading towards Erd's Crossing. And then we'll see what happens from there. So if I read the epic correctly, once we have taken care of the portion that we're about to go do, then we go to kill the guy for the Woe and Envy, which we've already done, as you saw. And then finally we're going to move on to the next part, which I think it goes from patience to wisdom, and then the last one. All right, let me lock this real quick. But anyway, guys, that's pretty much it. That's all I wanted to show you today. I'm going to have to go out into this hallway, and hopefully nobody attacks me. In the stairway here. There we go. And I'm trying to decide. Should I just go ahead? I should go ahead and just invis out. That way I am able to get a port in West Sea and then head over there. But thank you all for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. And if you have any questions, please let me know in those comments below. Like if you liked it and subscribe if you want to see more. I'll see you next time. This is Cipher Deck. Peace out.